In this video, I will turn this hard bolt into this life sensor with a thrust bearing. Good day, brothers. Let's start by facing the head of the bolt. I don't like to face to the sensor with carbide tools because I'm afraid that I will break it. So I use either a file to finish or high speed steel tool. And with interrupted cuts, I use high speed steel. I will use this pipe for the bearing housing. Don't laugh on my tacking technique. I am using the 7018 to weld the two pieces together. I made this life sensor when I bought this lathe. I used an old car tapered bearing, and as you can see, it is too big and too long for Morris taper too. But I learned a lot while making it and using it. Please don't forget to press the like button. I am turning this band to indicate on for more accuracy when I flip the part. I hate turning welds, they are usually hard and can easily break my precious carbide. This indication is not important. It is only so I don't turn more than that I need from the outside. This is for the thrust bearing seat. I can't see anything. So when the tool starts to scream, I know that I am at the limit. Now to turn the Morris taper, I will use this chuck to copy it. I will keep tapping with this dead blue hammer until the needle stops moving. This is the most important indication in the whole project, so take your time if you are making one like this. Sanding the taper will make it fit and stick much better to the tail stuff. I clean the lathe bed after sanding. I am making the life center a bit shorter, so I can retract it more inside the tail stock for more rigidity. This through hole is for oiling the thrust bearing and removing the revolving center to put another type or to repair it. This is so I don't tap more than that I need in this relatively hard steel. I sharpen this drill bit for the head of the screw. The lathe is at 48 RPMs. I need to make a tapping holder for this kind of work. best thing that could happen to me right now. The only successful way to remove a broken tap. 60% of the time, it works every time. I will cut the screw short to fit it here. I will make the revolving center from this hard steel. It does my high speed steel tool fast, and if it isn't hard enough, I can harden it more. I indicated on the turned band off cam. I am setting the compound slide to 30 degrees. That will make the revolving center at 60 degrees. I am feeling any vibration that are not coming from the lathe, and there aren't any. I am taking 1 millimeter from the outside diameter. And now 2 millimeters. When the tool hits the step, it will be 3 millimeters from the OD. Almost 20 microns or 1 thou on this rough surface. And I didn't even tweak the tailstock for more accuracy. It is good for now. I needed this tool to turn a long taper between centers.